what is the open-closed principle, the O in SOLID?
Yeah, the open-closed principle states that systems should be open for extension and closed for modification. What does that mean? Basically, it means that when you have a component and you want to add code, you don't want to go and change stuff inside the component.
So instead of code, let's use the word feature. Let's say you want to add a new feature to the system.
Yeah.
It should be adding something rather than changing the system to do the new thing. When you can just add a new feature without changing the current feature, you have less work, first of all, less risk of breaking something, right? It's an additive thing.
Exactly.
And that's the dream.
Yeah.
Once you be able to add features by adding new code rather than changing old code. Because changing old code, especially if you don't have tests, that's risky. And that's a different story.
Yep.
You should have tests. But even if you have tests, every time you go there and you change code, it means you don't have a very modular system.
No.
You cannot just go and bring new behaviors easily.
There are multiple ways to achieve that, basically, right?
For example?
Open-closed systems need the proper abstractions in place, you know, in order to be open-closed, basically. And you can achieve that, you know, with a polymorphism. And, like, you need to be able to have a very good a method for composing these things, right? For composing components. Otherwise, like, you can't build on top of already, you know, like, implemented code.
Yes, because if you can compose a system differently to do different things without changing it, just by composing it differently, then you have an open-closed system because you just compose the objects differently and they do different things. So you can add behavior without changing existing code.
And perhaps this makes the single responsibility principle, a bit more clear why you need it. Because if you encapsulate all this logic of one responsibility, right, in just one component, then you can use around this component. You can reuse and compose it in different ways.
Exactly. Because like those principles are not isolated things. To conform to the open-closed principle, you need to follow the other principles as well.
Pretty much. The open-closed principle is like a computed principle. It's like the result of the result. If you follow the other principles, that's what you get. You get an open-closed system.
So what is an example of the open-closed principle in practice, let's say in iOS?
A classic one. You have a UI view controller, and this view controller presents a list of things, and the list, the data, come from a backend, right? From a remote service.
From the network, right. A network request.
Yes. Next feature, well, we want to show the same list in case the customer doesn't have an internet connection.
So you want to cache the results of the requests somehow? And if you don't have internet connection, you want to present the cached version.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So the view controller was fetching it from the network, but now it needs to fetch from the cache if the network fails. So that's a new feature. You are adding a new behavior.
But like for the UI view controller, that should not matter because the UI view controller should have, you know, like its own responsibilities of managing the views lifecycle and rendering the views and all that stuff. But the loading from the remote location or from the local location, you know, like that's a completely different matter.
Right. It shouldn't matter for the view controller where the data comes from.
No.
It can come from the network, from disk, from an in-memory store. It doesn't matter.
Exactly.
But for it not to matter, you need to implement a good abstraction.
Yes.
Right. You need to hide details about the network. You need to hide details about a local store.
Yes.
Behind a good interface, like a protocol, maybe a closure.
Yes.
Because if you can do it, then it means that you can add this feature without changing any line of code in the view controller.
Yep.
So that means that your view controller is open for extension. You added a new behavior, but closed for modification. You didn't have to modify it to add this new behavior.
No, you don't have to change the inside of the UI view controller subclass there, right?
Yes.
It's just stuff that goes around it, right? That you need to add.
And this is about a component like a view controller, a class.
Mm-hmm.
But it can follow the same principle to higher level modules. You can add behaviors to an entire module by injecting something different to it, you know, by composing it differently, by using any kind of polymorphic interface that allows you to add behavior without changing any code inside the module, the component, the class.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. And that's a, you know, like something that you should strive for.
Okay, so what are some violations? What are the bad things that can happen if you violate the open-closed principle?
Right. So in the example that we mentioned with the remote and the local loader, data loader, imagine if, let's say, the view controller knew where this the data came from, right? Like we're talking about the provenance of the data. If that's the case, then you're violating it because the view controller knows about a concrete location or a concrete type, rather, that the data come from. So when you will need to change that, you're going to have to change the guts of the UI view controller.
Okay, so if the view controller depends directly, let's say, on URL session for fetching this data, or any kind of network component for fetching this data, and now you want to add a cache, you need to change the view controller to allow this new behavior. So your view controller is not open for extension. No. You need to change it to add new behavior. And that's going to be more work. You're going to have to test things in integration, and it's going to be messy. It's going to be slow.
Yep. You said it best. It's going to be more work and more risk. You know, like this is...
Exactly what you don't want.
Yeah, exactly.
You want to go fast, right? It needs to be easy to add new features, right? It shouldn't require changes in multiple modules. You should just add, compose things differently, and that's it.
That's okay. So what you're saying now is another thing that you should be mindful about, right? So if, let's say you have a new feature or, you know, a requirement, something, and you find yourself having to add, you know, change like multiple code in multiple places in a project, then you're breaking the open-close principle.
Yeah. Because let's say there's two other developers working in the same system and they're also changing multiple modules.
Yes.
What are the chances you're going to collide at some point and have merge conflicts or break each other's code, get in each other's way? It's going to be much harder to work in collaboration. It's going to be much harder to maintain these long-term, to compose this system in different ways.
Exactly.
And that's why you need to be mindful, as you said, discipline.
Yeah, you need to look for the signals. Look for the habits that you have in your behavior. When you find them, you can start correcting them if they're wrong.
And to be fair, you cannot comply to the open-close principle like 100%. You cannot have your whole system in a way that you can add features all the time without changing code. Some features are going to break your initial assumptions and require change. That's fine.
Yes.
Right? You cannot comply to it 100%. You cannot think about all the scenarios of the future. And you shouldn't as well.
Exactly.
Otherwise, you're going to be paralyzed.
Exactly. You shouldn't.
But changes should not require like cascading changes in the code base.
Yes.
And as you learn more about the system, you create better and better design, better abstractions. So you start understanding more how this system is going to change over time. Because you see like what part of the business is flourishing. And that's more likely for them to ask more features, add more functionality in there.
Yeah.
Thus, that's the part they should probably abstract a little bit more than the others. And over time, you're going to learn more about the system and improve it. And you keep tuning. So every time there's a new change, it's easy to add. And it doesn't require changes everywhere. So you cannot comply to it 100%, but should comply to it as much as you can. And improve, adjust over time. And that's it. Discipline.
Yep.
Mindfulness.